वेलकम टू द ई क्लास ऑफ डिपॉल स्कूल बारीपदा। गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, आई तापस सर, योर लैंग्वेज टीचर। टुडे I am going to teach grammar way for standard 4 students. Today's lesson is very important because it is in your Happily exam course. Lesson number 10. So children, before I start the video, it is very important you should listen it very attentively, because if you are not going to listen it, you cannot understand what I am saying in this video. So today's lesson is simple present tense. And as you know, tense, it is very important for everyone to understand it clearly, what is tense is all about. So today's lesson about tense. So let's start the lesson, children. There are three forms of tenses. They are present, past and future tense. Present tense or simple present tense is a part of the present tense of verb. It tells us about an action that happened in the present. Means whatever work or whatever action is going on, if it is at the present time, now the action is going on, it is said to be simple present tense. We usually add s or es to the verb with he, she, it and singular nouns. Means in simple present tense, we generally use s or es to the verb with the subject when it is he, she, it. They are singular nouns or pronouns. If it is he, she, it is singular noun pronoun. If we are writing any singular noun, there also we have to use s or es. Now I will show you some examples. We will see how we add s or es to the sentences in simple present tense. First one, he walks to the bus stop every day. Here he is singular pronoun, so you can see walk is the verb. It is s it added to the verb, it becomes walks. So he walks to the bus stop every day. She watches television for half an hour in the evening. She also singular pronoun, so we have to add es to the verb watch, watches. Can you see the dog? It barks all the time. Here it is a singular pronoun, so we have to use verb bark, b-a-r-k. We have to use s to it to make it barks. Then comes Preeti makes tasty mango ice cream. Here you can see Preeti is a noun, but Preeti we are talking about a girl, so it is singular noun. So here also you can see make is the verb and s is added to it, makes. Preeti makes tasty mango ice cream. Next one, my father drives the car very fast. Father is singular noun, so singular noun we add drive, d-r-i-v-e, s drives to the verb, s we have added here. Because as I told you, every verb, whether it is with a singular pronoun or singular noun, we have to add s or es in its simple present tense form. When we talk about plural pronoun or noun, there no need of adding any s or es. We use the root or the base form of the verb with I, we, you, they and plural pronouns. Means whatever the main or the base form of a verb, we generally use that only. No need of adding any s or es to it if the subject is I, we, you, they or any plural nouns. Examples, I drink 8 glasses of water every day. You can see I, it is a plural pronoun. So no S or ES added to drink. It is simply root form of the verb drink. No S or ES to it. We read story books in the evening. Here also we use a plural pronoun. So verb no S, ES. So just read. We read story books in the evening. You plural pronoun. You play badminton really well. Play is the verb, main verb in the sentence, but we don't use ES to it. Mohan and Sohan go for piano classes every Saturday. Mohan and Sohan are name of two boys. It is in plural form. So you see, verb, main verb go is there, not goes, G-O, ES to it. So here when the subject is singular, we add S or ES to it. When the subject is plural, we don't use S or ES to it. Negative sentence. A negative sentence that state an action does not happen. Means when we write no or not, do not, does not, did not, that shows that the work is not being done. That means it is negative sentence. So first we start with he does not drink milk daily. He, John and Betty do not love chocolate. You can see both the case not is used. First one with does not, second one is do not. These two sentences shows that they are in negative sentence or they are in negative form. So how we generally use do not or does not in a sentence, now I will tell you. We use do and the base form of the verb with I, we, you, they and plural nouns. Means when the subject is I, we, you, they or any plural noun, there we have to use do. Remember, see the examples. I do not ride my bicycle every day. As I told you, when we add not to a sentence, it becomes negative. But where to use do not and where to use does not, this is the question. As I told you, when the subject is plural, pronoun or noun, plural form, there we have to use do not. So I, we, you and Nana, Kanika, they, these are all plural pronouns and nouns. So you can see all these sentences having do not. So first is I do not ride my bicycle every day. We do not like milkshake. We also plural, so do not. You do not get to talk to me like that. So you also plural, do not. Nana and Kanika, two girls, so it is plural. So here also do not. Nana and Kanika do not have a house in their locality, in this locality. Next, last one, they is plural pronoun. They do not like to play basketball. So all do not is added to the subject which is having plural pronoun or plural noun. We use does not and the base form of the verb with he, she, it and singular noun. Now, where to use does not? When the subject is singular pronoun or singular noun, in that case we have to use does not. As we know, pronoun he, she, it are singular. He, she, it are singular pronoun. So in this case we have to use does not. First is he does not sing in the choir. He is singular, so does not. She does not clean her room daily. So she is plural, so does not. It does not bark at my friends. It also singular pronoun, so does not. Rohan does not write neatly. Rohan is a singular noun, so here also does not. You can see he, she, it and Rohan are singular pronoun and noun. So in this case we have to use does not to make the sentence negative. Next, the exercise part of the lesson, forming question forming question is a simple present tense using question word. Means now how to change the sentence into negative or using do or does, or how to where to use do or where to use does. Now we will I will tell you in this first one, question word plus do plus I, we, you, they or plural noun plus base form of the verb where question word is there, like what, then do, then pronoun I, then verb, base form of the verb read. So what do I read? You can see I is you, do is used here where we have plural pronouns I, and second one, where do you play? I and we are two plural pronoun, so in that case just add do to it to make the sentence, because when the pronouns are plural form there we use do. So what do I read? Question mark. Where do we play? Question mark. Here in both these sentences we have plural pronouns I and we, so we have to add do. Second one, question word plus does plus he, she, it, singular noun plus base form of the verb. Where, question word, does, he, singular pronoun, go to swim, go is the base form of the verb, to swim is also the base form of the verb. So where does he go to swim? Second one, what does it eat? He and it in these two sentences are singular pronouns. Singular pronouns have does with them, like plural pronouns have do with them. Here in singular pronouns, he, she, it or any name, any boy or girl or anybody's name, singular name, there we have to use does. Now, do plus I, we, you, they, plural noun, base form of the verb. Same thing as I told you, do, when we make question with the help of do or does, we have to see whether the pronoun or noun is singular or plural. If it is plural, then we have to use do. Like, do I buy the green shirt? I is singular pronoun, so you have to use do to make it a question. Do I buy the green shirt? Do we go to the park? Question mark. Do Anil and Sunil play hockey? Question mark. All three sentences are interrogative sentence because they begins with verb do. Why do? Because all the sentence having plural pronouns or plural nouns. That's why if the noun or pronoun is plural, we have to use do to make it a question or interrogative sentence. Now, does plus he, she, it, singular noun plus base form of the verb. When we see the pronoun or noun is singular, there we have to use does to make it as a interrogative sentence. First one, does he drink milk? Does she like cakes? Does Ankita sing well? He, she are singular pronouns. Ankita is singular nouns. So before this singular noun and pronoun, we have to use does, because singular noun and pronoun only have does before them to make it as a interrogative sentence. Now, bit number A, fill in the blanks with the correct form of the verb in bracket. The carpenter makes, bracket, make furniture. Why makes? Because carpenter is a singular noun. As I told you before, that when the subject is singular, whether it is noun or pronoun, we have to use s or es to the base form of the verb. So carpenter is singular, so makes. The boy catches the ball in time, bracket, it is catch. Why it is catches? Because I told you boy is singular subject or singular noun, we have to add es to it, so it is catches. Third one, the artist sketches, bracket sketch, a scene by the river. Here, artist also singular, that's why ES added to it, sketches. John and Jean like, bracket like, chocolates but not toffees. Here, like is there in the bracket, but same like we have written in the blanks because the subject John and Jean are plural. Here, when the subject is plural, because two names are there, two boys' names are given here, two means plural. Plural case, we don't use S or ES to the root form of the verb. The verb remain as usual, like it is there. The base form is there, like. So, you have to keep that base form, like, in the answer also, because plural subject does not have S or ES to it. Then comes the fifth one, the students stick, bracket also, stick pictures of animals in their scrapbook. Here students is also plural subject, S is there, students. So we have to use that same root form of the verb stick. No need of adding any S or ES to it to make it a change, because singular noun or pronoun generally have the base form of their verb. Bit number B, rewrite the sentence by changing the underlined noun from singular to plural. Means the noun underlined in the question is a singular, change it into plural. Okay, first one, the washerman washes the clothes. Washerman, man, man. So it is singular. The washer, man, man. The washerman wash the clothes. Why wash, not washes? Because plural subject doesn't have S or ES. That's why the washerman wash the clothes. Second one, the gardener waters the plant. The gardener is singular. So when we change into plural, the gardeners water the plants. Here when the singular gardener change into plural, the verb doesn't have S to it. Before it was waters, now you see it is water, because now the subject is gardeners, not gardener. Before it was singular subject, so was water had S to it. Verb water was having S to it. But when the subject is changed into plural, the verb will not have any S or ES. So the correct answer is the gardeners waters the plant. Third one, my son eats sandwiches for breakfast. Son is singular, so eats is there. Now when the son will change into plural, sons. My sons eat sandwiches for breakfast. Eat is verb having S in the question, but when we write the plural subject, it changes it, no S to it. Fourth one, the driver drives the car. The answer will be the drivers drive the car. The driver drives the car, it was because driver singular. So verb base form was S, drives. But when the subject becomes plural, drivers, then base form of the verb will not have any S or ES. So the answer will be the drivers drive the car. Bit number C, rewrite the sentence by changing the underlined noun from plural to singular. If it is plural is there, change into singular. The children play in the park. The child plays in the park. When the subject becomes singular, verb will have S. My brothers love to play cricket. My brother loves to play cricket. The owls perch on the tree at night. The owls perches on the tree at night. The babies lie in the coat. The baby lies in the coat. You can see all the subject, child, brother, owl and baby are singular. That's why plays, S is added, loves, S is added, perches, ES is added, lies, S is added to it, because singular subject always have S or ES in the root form of the verb in simple present tense. So this lesson is over, children. Very important lesson, you know, tense. Without tense, you cannot write or you cannot know in which form the sentence is, it present, past or for future. So it is very important that you should again and again see this video and try to understand whatever I have told in this video, and practice the exercise part of it also. Very important, not only for your exam, for your future as well. So my request to you children, don't waste time now, because we have very less time left for our exam. So very soon we'll start the revision questions. So first you try to understand the lesson by watching this video and practicing the exercise part. If you repeatedly do at home, I'm sure you will not have any doubt regarding this lesson, simple present tense. It is very easy, but minute your changes are there. So that thing you have to notice. If you watch this video repeatedly, surely you will follow that thing, and it will be a great help in doing or changing or seeing whether the sentence is simple present or simple past or simple future. It is easy to understand. Thank you children for watching this video, and my request to you, don't waste the time. Use the time now, because very hard time is going on for our life now. So this medium is very important to use, make it as a habit to prepare for your future courses. And also you give time to your studies, because after all everything cannot stop. I know it is very hard time now, but you have to continue our studies, you have to think about your exam, future, everything you have to do. So it is important to watch the lessons what the teachers are teaching or what they are giving you as the exercise work. Please practice at home, read at home again and again, listen to your parents, obey their advice and respect your elders. Till we meet again with such video, goodbye, best of luck for your exam and for your future. Thank you.